coming up on the 3rd of August here on BBC 4. Feast of his operas as well at the Proms. Indeed, the composer originally thought that Till Eulenspiegel would be a stage work.
And as an opera singer, of course, I can completely understand the appeal. There is wonderful descriptive power and very vivid characterization in the instrumental colors there. But as it happened, Strauss had one failed opera under his belt, and it had only happened the year before in 1893, an opera called Guntram. And he was worried that the material for Till wouldn't quite stretch out for a whole opera. He actually put it in a letter. He said Till was a rogue with too superficial a dramatic personality.
You get a bit of Rosenkavalier there.
Definitely,
don't you?
We were saying that, yeah.
Well, next tonight, a young violinist for whom David Zimmerman has been something of a mentor. Julia Fischer has recorded Dvorak's violin concerto with him. Together, they've made it something of a mission to champion the work. It's partly personal for Julia. Dvorak, the great Czech composer, her mother was born in what was then Czechoslovakia, and this was also the first concerto that she ever played.
Well, I know that she feels this concerto has been vastly underrated next to the acknowledged greats that we know, like Bruch, Mendelssohn, Brahms. I must say, Brahms himself championed Dvorak. I'm a huge fan of Dvorak. I tend to agree there was so much more to his musical legacy than the chestnuts we know, like the New World Symphony, the American Quartet, Rusalka, which I adore. Dvorak, I would say, was one of the very patriotic composers, nationalist. He really drew upon the varied rhythms and the melodies that were so colorful of his bohemian folk songs of his native Czech homeland. And it gave his music a very unmistakable national identity. I'm so pleased Julia is championing this work.
So a chance for the soloist to show what she's made of. Julia Fischer says of the Dvorak Violin Concerto, it has the most beautiful beginning of all violin concertos.
Thank you. Thank you.
amazing performance by Julia Fischer with David Zinman. I'm still reeling from that, Hitchcock. It was, it's like they've danced that dance before. It's wonderful to see two people so comfortable with each other. I almost felt like I was in their living room.
Yeah, you can tell that relationship has a lot of history to it on concert hall platforms and in rehearsal rooms. She reminds me of one of those great Central European virtuosi of the late 19th, early 20th century, a wonderful richness to her sound, but the virtuosity somehow very contained. No fireworks just for the sake of fireworks.
Right.
It's wonderfully restrained.
What I loved about Julia Fischer's performance is that she just allowed herself to feel her way through it. She clearly feels so connected to this rep. I mean, this must be for her the umpteenth performance since she's played it since she was a child. It was just stunning. She's gonna come back.
That telltale stamp, which means they want an encore, and here she comes.
From the Sonata in G minor by Paul Hindemith. Thank you.
What a wonderful choice for an encore, a surviving fragment of a lost violin sonata by Paul Hindemith.